In the earlier session, we discussed about exercise 1, and after that, the next concept is estimation and rounding of numbers. To understand this one, let us take few examples. This one here, you can say that approximately. Nearly 2000 people daily visit Tirupati. Here, if you take these examples here, what we are saying, approximately 9 lakh students appear SSC exam this year. Here, this 9 lakh is not an exact number. Since we don't know the exact number, we are estimating this number. We are taking around 9 lakh students will appear this year. We are saying like that. So, this is not an exact number. This is an approximately we are saying this number. Similarly, here, nearly 2000 people daily visit Tirupati. You don't know how many people, just we are estimating that nearly 2000 people. It may be 1900, it may be 2100. So here just we are estimating up to 2000 daily visits Tirupati, nearly visits Tirupati. So here to estimate any number, just we have to round off these numbers. Now let us see few examples. If they ask what is the nearest number to 83. Here, if you want to find what is the nearest number to 83, we know that it is a two-digit number. Here, just you have to check in this number lies between which tens. You know that this number lies between 80 to 90. In between 80 to 90, this number will locate. So here, let us see where will it locate. Take this as 80. After that, 81, 82, 83. Is nearer to 83, we have to represent. So here you know that this 83 lies between 80 and 90. And where is 83 here? 83 is located here. You can observe that 83 is so far to 90. Because in between how many numbers are there? You have 6 numbers are there. See here, you can observe that 83 is very nearer to 80. Because in between only 2 numbers are there. So here you can observe that 83 is nearer to 80 compared to that of the 90. So we can say that the rounding of number of 83 is 80. Because here if you see the number 90, it is so far when compared to that of the 80. So you have to take the nearest number of 83 is 80. And after that here, if you have given the number 86, let us consider the number 86. Here, where is 86 here? You know that it is 86. Now see here, you have to check this 86, like this number is nearest to either 80 or 90. You have to check that one. Here you can observe that if you see the number 90, here it is very nearer to this number because in between only 3 numbers are there. Here if you can observe here 80, you can observe that it is so far. How many numbers are there in between? In between 5 numbers are there. So we can say that the nearest number of 86 is 90. Here you can observe that in between these two numbers, what will be the number 85? Before 85, all the numbers are nearer to 80, and after 85, all the numbers. You know that 86 is nearer to 90, and after that we took here the number 82, and 82 is nearer to 80. Now we took the number 85. 85, here you can observe that 85 is lies in between the center. It is here in between 82 and 85, 4 numbers are there. Here also in between 85 to 90, 4 numbers are there. So, but by convention, you always say that 85 is nearer to 90. This is the estimation of the number. If you have given the number, just you have to check that number lies between which numbers. So that you can say that number is nearer to which number. Now, based on this concept, let us solve exercise, next exercise. Round up the following numbers to the nearest tens. You have to round up the number to the nearest tens. Here is the question. They mentioned you have to round up the number to the nearest tens. First question, they have given the number 89. Now, you have to check this 89 lies between which tens. Since here they ask the nearest tens. So, since it is a 10 digit number, you have to check this number lies between which number and which number. You know that this 89 lies in between 80 to 90. Now here, let us draw the numbers here. 80, 81, 82. 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90. Here they have given the number 89. Here you can observe that 89 is very nearer to 90. Since after 89 you are getting the number 90. If you see the number 80, it is so far. In between 8 numbers are there. So we can say that the nearest number of 89 is 90. Here, right? Is 90. Here, there is no need to represent all these numbers. Just you have to check the middle number. And after that, if it is lies on the right side, you have to take the last number. And if it is lying the right side, you have to take the first number. Now, see the next question. 450. Here, you can observe that it is a 3-digit number, but in the question, they ask you round off the number to the nearest 10. So, you have to take only the 10 number. Here, you can observe that this 15 lies between which number and which number? You know that this 15 lies between 10 to 20. In between 10 to 20, 15 will be located. So you have to take the number in between 410 and 420. Understood here? Since here they have given the 3-digit number, but in the question they ask to write the nearest tens. So you have to take the 10-digit number. In between, what is the 10-digit number? You know that 15 is a 10-digit number, and 15 lies between which tells 10 to 20. In between 10 to 20, this 15 will be located. So you have to take the numbers in between 410 to 420. Now, right? After that, what you get? 411, 412, 413, 414, 415, 416, 417, 480, 490, and 420. So here you can observe that what is the given number 450, and by convention we already discussed this 450 is nearer to 420. So here write 450 nearer to 420. Understood? Now see the next question.
This number will be located. So here
You know that after this number you will get 36,151 and 36,152. We already discussed here. If you take the middle number, if you go to the right side of the number, that number is nearer to the number 36,200. Here clearly, if you take this number 152, this 152 will lies between 100 and 200. In between 100 and 200, what is the middle number? You know that 150 is the middle number. So here, what is the nearest number to 36,150? Which is 36,200. Here, right? 36,150 is nearest to 36,200. Remaining two questions are there. That is your homework. Now, see the third question. Here they ask you write to the nearest thousands. First question, they ask you round up the numbers to the nearest tens, and the next one hundreds. Now they ask to nearest take the rounding of the number to the nearest thousands. Here the first question, 3,450. You have to take the 4-digit number here. So you know that it is a thousand number. This number lies between 1,000 and 6,000, which is nothing but 3,000 to 4,000. In between 3,000 to 4,000, this number will be located. So here, in between 3,000 to 4,000, what will be the middle number? You know that 3,000. What will be the middle number? 3,500. Right? Here, you have to consider the this number is located between 6,000. You have to take first here. You know that this 3,415 will lie between 3,000 to 4,000. In between 3,000 to 4,000, what will be the middle number? 3,500. Now check here, 3,415. This 3,415 lies between this range or this range. You can clearly see that this 3,415 lies between in these numbers. Right? So we can clearly observe that this 3,415 is nearer to 3,000 compared to that of the 4,000. Right? Here this number is given. First you have to write this number is located between which thousands. Here this number is located between 3,000 to 4,000, and in the middle 3,500 will be there. Now what is the given number? 3,450. You have to check this number lies between this range or this range. Clearly you can observe that this number lies between these numbers, and this number is nearer to 3,000. So write it here, 3,450 is nearer to 3,000. Okay. Now see one more question. Here you have to consider this number will located between which thousand and which thousand. You know that this number lies between 70,000 to 80,000. Right? In between 70,000 to 80,000, in the middle, in between these numbers, you are getting this number. So here, write the middle number here. What will be the middle number? 70,000. The middle number will be 70,500, and the last number will be 80,000. This will be the middle number. Now you have to check this number. This number lies between this range or this range. That means this number is located between in these numbers or these two numbers. You can clearly observe that 70,124 will come in between these two numbers, right? Here 124 is there, here 500 is there. Clearly you can observe that this 70,124 will come in between these two numbers. So this number is nearer to which number? 70,000 compared to that of the 80,000. Here write 70,124 is nearer to 70,000. Just if you have given the consider thousands, you have to consider the given number lies between which thousands. After that, you have to consider the middle number. And after that, just check this number lies between this range or this range. If it is lies between this range, you have to consider the first number. And if it lies between the second range, you have to consider the last number. Remaining two questions is your homework. Next, we will, in the next class, we are going to discuss about the expansion.